Hi everyone, this is the first video in series of recordings about using decision tree for visual analysis of alternative project decisions. As you know, decision trees are tree-like graphs that show the process of decision making and its consequences, including chance event outcomes, resource costs, and utility. We will be using Precision Tree, which is a useful add-on for Excel spreadsheets. The first step will be creating the logic of Decision Tree, which I will explain for you using a bidding decision example. For explaining different steps of a Decision Tree analysis, I will be using a bidding decision example. As you can see, our company decides wants to decide to bid or not to bid for a project. We know about some of deterministic inputs for this particular project. For example, the cost of placing a bid for this one is $60,000. This is about preparing the documentations and other related costs. Also, the project itself takes us $1.45 million to complete, and this is definitely our expenses in this project. And there is 80% chance that we are competing with other companies in the tendering process. So we haven't entered this process yet, we don't know for certain, and we estimate that there is 80% chance that other companies are interested and will bid for this project. The company is thinking to three values for bid: $1.7, $1.8, and $1.9 million. We have done some research, and we understand that 40% of competitors are likely to place bid less than $1.7 million. There is 15% chance that they bid for values between $1.7 and $1.8 million, and there is 25% chance that competitors bid for values between $1.8 and $1.9 million. Also, it is likely that only 20% of companies bid for values greater than $1.9 million. Based on this known data, we can calculate the probability of winning our bid. For example, if we are bidding for $1.7 million, because 40% of other companies are going to bid for less than that, our chance of winning is 1 minus 40%, which is equal to 60%. Similarly, for our bid, $1.8 million, because a total of 40% plus 15% of competitors are going to bid for less than that, our chance for winning this by bidding $1.8 million is 1 minus 40% minus 15%, which is equal to 45%. And similarly for $1.9 million bid, because a total of 40% plus 15% plus 25% of competitors are bidding less than that, our chance for winning is only 20%. So after these basic calculations, we are now ready to create the logic of decision tree using decision nodes and chance nodes. We will be using two types of nodes in our decision tree: squares or decision nodes when we want to make a decision, and chance nodes or circles when there is uncertainty about a decision or its consequences. So, the first decision we should make with regard to this particular project is to bid for this new project or not. So we put it in the first triangle, and two branches out of that, yes and no. The second decision that our company should make is that how much the value of bid should be. And we have three options of 1.7, 1.8, and 1.9 million dollars. So three branches in total. After drawing decision nodes in squares, this is now time to draw chance nodes in circles. We will be using two chance nodes, first for probability of any competing bids, which is 80%. It means that when we bid for this project, there is 80% chance that other companies are also interested and bidding to win this project. The second chance node that we are using is the probability of winning for different values of bids. For example, when we bid for $1.7 million, there is 60% chance of winning and 40% chance of losing. And also we have computed other chances for winning for other values of bids. So we can draw different chance nodes in circles, and as you can see, we have these chance nodes for defining 80% competition and 20% not competition, and we have these chance nodes for probability of winning. I have drawn the first one for you, and the rest can be drawn in the same way. Let's see what happens if our bid of $1.7 million win. We know that there are certain expenses for placing the bid and also completing the project. In this case, we have to spend $60,000 for placing a bid and $1.45 million for completing the project. So the difference between our bidding value, i.e. $1.7 million, and these two expenses will be our profit. In this case, it is $190,000. But what happens if we do not win the tender? We have spent $60,000 for placing a bid, and there is no gained value. So our profit will be minus $60,000. As you see, these calculations are shown in our decision tree. For a bid of $1.8 million, there is 45% chance that we gain $290,000 and 55% chance of losing $60,000. For a bid of $1.9 million, there is 15% chance of gaining $390,000 and 85% chance of losing $60,000. As you can see, it is a complicated decision-making process, and to find out the optimal decision in terms of bidding value, we can use a technique called expected monetary value or EMV. It helps us in the process of decision making. Now we can use the technique of expected monetary value or EMV to analyze our decision making process. There are three different scenarios. We can bid for $1.7 million. In this case, there is 60% chance of having a profit of $190,000 and 40% chance of losing $60,000, which is the cost for placing bid. So it gives us a profit of $90,000. If we consider the first possibility, which is winning this project in competition with other companies, because we have 80% chance of winning and it is times by $90,000 profit, it gives us a profit of $72,000. But in the second possibility, we can win the project without competition with others. It means that we are the only bidder, and our profit is bigger, $190,000 times by 20% chance, and it gives us profit of $38,000. The expected monetary value for this scenario is the sum of $72,000 and $38,000, which will be $110,000. Similarly, for the second scenario of bidding for $1.8 million, we can expect a monetary value of $136,000. And for the final scenario of bidding $1.9 million, the potential profit is $84,000. Among these three scenarios, the best option and the optimal decision is to bid for $1.8 million. So the company should bid for this project, and the optimum bidding value is $1.8 million. This is the basis of decision making in precision tree software. And it is good to know how the optimal decision is made in this software. In the next video, I will show you how to draw the skeleton of decision tree in precision tree software. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel for updated videos on engineering management.